Okay, today we're going to talk about a very good cruising fuel system. In our opinion, we tried to make King's Pride, the vessel we're on, have kind of a top-notch fuel system. Art's here with me, he's behind the cameras, but we started by pulling both of the tanks out of this boat, got everything cleaned. In order to do that, we've got a tech tip, we put in inspection ports, and so those are all done. Reinstalled tanks, new fuel fills that come in. What we have is the main fuel tank, 45 gallons down here, and then we have an auxiliary, another 35 gallons up in the quarter berth. The really great thing about this system is you use 100% of the fuel up in that tank, because we just have a valve you open, and when there's room in here, you just drain it down in, and you can use all of that fuel. The fuel that's in this tank, what we're going to do is, before you go out and do a big passage, or twice a year maybe if you're, you know, just doing local cruising, is we've got a fuel sampling port, a stripping port that goes all the way down to the bottom of the tank, the very lowest spot, and you can just pull a sample off and ensure and make sure you're keeping the water and the crud off from the bottom of this tank. And we also, along the way, we've added a port, so if somebody wanted to put on a diesel furnace in the Northwest or a generator or something, so it's always good to have extra pickups into your fuel system. Now, if you don't have this on your fuel system, look down in the show notes. You can buy, when we put in furnaces here in the Pacific Northwest, they make a little add a dip tube, add a fuel pickup for a furnace that you can drill a single hole in your tank and pop that thing in, so you can add a stripping port to any existing fuel. That is the biggest problem we have with contamination with fuel, is leaving water and gunk at the bottom of it. So we want to make sure that we've got that out. So that's step one.
Yep.
In the zone. All right, so down here, Greg, new owner, is going to appreciate the fuel system. We've got our stripping port. We did a couple of adapters and some P-clamps and tied it down. We have an outboard motor fuel primer bulb, which of course is not rated technically for diesel, but diesel is less offensive than gasoline. And this whole system, you have it shut off, really lives outside of the fuel area here. And it's going to make a nice system. So it's going to probably take a little bit the first time to get it primed, but this goes to the very bottom of that tank. And when we open the valve, we should be able to just do a little bit of priming here. Okay, now I used a little tiny container here because we got brand new fuel. I'd be using a liter bottle or something with a top on it, of course, that you can pull your sample. But you pull your fuel out and then let it sit. And of course, if you have any water contaminants, anything that's going to show up,
the Italian dressing will be waiting at the bottom.
The Italian dressing. And so, just like that, perfect fuel system. Is you got to start with a good clean system. If you've got a used boat, I would recommend you start by opening up the tanks and getting them clean, and then you're going to have a great system. The only thing you're going to need to add to the diesel fuel is a little biocide whenever you fill up. Then, to make the system even better, we run it through a Raycor 500 series, and as we do that, we put a vacuum gauge in, so you can always do your daily engine room checks. On this boat, you open up a pair of doors, you look in there, you can see your sea basket, you can look for leaks, you can check the vacuum level on the fuel filter. So there's another tech tip we did about that. The vacuum gauge is key. And then, next thing we did, ensuring we get clean fuel to this, is we made it super easy to change that primary Raycor filter by installing an electric priming pump. And so watch this. All you got to do is, normally the fuel runs through the bypass and the pump is offline. When you see your vacuum gauge goes up and it's time to change that filter, all you got to do is close the little crossover valve right here, and then the fuel goes from the tank through the pump, and you just turn on, you push the little momentary switch, and it's going to fill that filter right to the top. No more air. We get that done, then you go into the secondary on your motor. Same thing, you don't have to use the little hand-activated lift pump if you've got an electric pump installed. You spin off your cartridge fuel filter, you spin on another one. Remember, you never pre-fill those. Those have to go on dry, because you can't ensure that that fuel is clean, and it's going into a high pressure fuel pump at that point. So we put that one on, open up the bleed screw, and same thing, we turn that pump on, and now it's pulling the fuel from the tank, it's pushing it through the Raycor, we fill up that secondary fuel filter, we close that off, and you should be able to do a fuel filter change in this boat in 10 or 15 minutes. Super easy, nice and clean, and then you are ready for another season. Cross an ocean, do whatever you want to do. So few great little tips on building a fuel system that works that you as a boat owner could either have installed or do yourself. So you got to have a stripping port that pulls out. You want to have a simple system for changing the filters. The electric priming pump is the way to go. Keep clean fuel going to your diesel motor, and once it starts, it should never let you down. Thanks for watching.